Employers of Reddit that do a background check on Facebook. What's the most disturbing thing you have seen? The place at which I am a board member fired someone this week for social media, posting pictures of vulnerable individuals and making fun of people with Down syndrome on a personal Facebook. A family member notified staff about the posting. The staff member thought it was outrageous to be fired from the camp for special needs kids for the posts. Making fun of people with Down syndrome on a personal Facebook. Whoa. Fired from the camp for special needs kids. Jesus freaking Christ. And here I thought it couldn't get any worse. I wouldn't necessarily call it disturbing, but it was the deciding factor in not hiring somebody. We interviewed a guy for an entry-level position. His interview went well and the other two people on the hiring committee were enthusiastic about him, but something about him bothered me. I don't normally check applicants out on Facebook, but I decided to in this case. His most recent post was something to the tune of, "Just got fired again. This is so much bulls." Someone asked him in the comments what happened, and his response was, "It was my third no-call no-show. I was too hungover to bother. Those buttholes had it coming for scheduling me right after a holiday," entitled, "Irresponsible," and daft enough to broadcast it in a public post, "Sign me up." I've had applicants say this type of crap to my face in an interview. A guy who said he had an assault charge 15 years ago. He wasn't lying. But that was the start of 27 pages of criminal history that included 2 years of incarceration, during which time it is upset he was self-employed as a carpenter. The history was predominantly assaults, thefts and possession of illegal drugs. I had never before seen 27 pages of criminal history on one person. I will add this though, he actually did turn his life around. He ended up working at the gym I went to and then got an additional job at a seafood distributor. I never would have guessed that he was the guy that would turn it all around, but he did. He was hired before I started, much before, but had been doing an audit of our files and I noticed his background check had a conviction for child molestation, or something like that. In the 80s. This was a man my boss regularly had play Santa at Christmas parties, where children would sit on his lap. This was the moment I realized the president of the company was a total idiot, but that guy got fired for insubordination like a year ago, so there's that. Frick, background checks for anyone that works with children. Not an employer, but handle work comp claims. Just had a guy claiming complete incapacity while going on 4 trips to Asia and back, as well as hyping his business all on his Facebook page. Just sent a subpoena for his business records, so should be fun. I get assigned interns to work with me based on a term or year from the university nearby. I make it a habit to do a quick Facebook search so I'll recognize their faces from the dozen other interns when they come in. Lots of party pics, smoking weed pics, legal hair, so in the same realm as those party pics, and women in almost no clothing. Also lots of mirror ab shots, though my field is largely female dominated, and all I look for is the profile picture. I don't do any digging. All the interns I've actually seen get hired have had very normal profile pictures, you know, smiling, with friends, on a hike, etc. Not because of their pics, but because they're the type of people who understand professional versus private life, and what is appropriate for public viewing. This is important. A lot of idiots get pent up about not being allowed to post anything or say anything. You can be into BDSM or beating people, as long as you don't display that to the community or location you work for. I was doing background checks for the British Airport Authority during a massive hiring drive in 2007, after there was an attempt to drive a car full of gas canisters into the terminal of Glasgow Airport by two Islamist wankers. Due to the need to hire several thousand staff in a few months, the normal requirements relating to job stability etc. were relaxed, so people who hadn't worked in 10-20 years were getting interviewed, which led to a few interesting ones. The only one which I can remember in detail was a guy from Belfast. He hadn't worked since 1990, but they were willing to give him a chance. When we checked his history, he had spent 5 years in HMP The Maze due to being convicted of terrorist offenses before being released as part of the Good Friday Agreement. It turned out that the guy spent his life applying to jobs with long recruitment processes that he couldn't get due to his terrorism conviction, as that meant he was seen as an active job seeker and wouldn't lose his benefits. Remember Trainspotting when Renton tells the interviewers that he's a rage addict? Similar to that. Strangely enough, he wasn't invited for an interview. TLDR. A convicted terrorist applying for a job designed to catch terrorists. Related reminder that this was the terrorist attack where John Smeaton tore a tendon in his foot when he kicked one of the terrorists in the balls. I work for a background screening company. We do not do social media checks, though. We are incredibly thorough, because it can lead to a world of problems. For instance, if you find out that applicant is gay and deny him the job because he has a criminal record or something, not because he is a homosexual, he can claim discrimination and sue. Consumers have to be provided a copy of their background check after the research is done, so they will see that a social media search was conducted. Hope this makes sense. Pictures of them smoking weed or being belligerently drunk. Not that I personally care, but you're just asking for trouble, especially if you're going into a public sector job. Think of it as a reference. Only you're the one giving the feedback on yourself. I actually had one kid whose profile picture was him naked, cupping his Johnson with the caption "Dongs out for haram." Did I mention he had applied to our marketing and social media internship? Hire this man. We had a 40-something lady apply, and whilst doing usual checks we went to her Facebook to find her profile picture is of her, her husband and her daughter at a swingers party, all completely nude and her with a different man behind her. We were dumbstruck. This was actually on MySpace back in the day. I was hiring for a position that involved review of patient medical records in a hospital setting, and as you can imagine, involved a great deal of confidentiality and discretion by the person hired for the position. One of the applicants worked at a bank, but had some prior experience in the medical field, so I was considering her for the position. I checked out her MySpace page and found tons of pictures of her in the bank vault, in her undies, posing suggestively with large amounts of money. The content of the pictures themselves didn't bother me so much as her complete lack of discretion and stupidity in posting those pictures publicly where any of her employers might have found them. I was disgusted thinking about what she may have done with others' private health information if we had hired her. Poses suggestively with medical records. I'm not an employer, but a few years after I resigned from a job that I'd worked at for years, I found I needed to contact my old grams. I called where I used to work and discovered he had quit, so I decided to look him up online. That's when I discovered that the guy I was working for prior to him becoming my GM had 2M convictions under his belt. I can't judge, though. He was one of the most awesome people I've ever worked for. I just thought it was funny. Confusing wording. I was trying to hire a nanny. This girl sends me her application. Everything looks really good. So I put her phone number into FB to see what she is like, and add her to mine. Her background photo is a girl, her, on all fours with a bra and panties on and a guy about to do a line off her butt. I was going to send her an email saying due to your FB page I will not be interviewing you. My husband told me not to, to help out other parents she is trying to get a job from. I check Facebook for all my hires. I love the ones who have their page public so I get to see all their crazy. Seriously, why try to get a job when you have worked at 10 plus jobs in the past year and laugh when you get fired for not doing your job, or when you post photos of doing stupid crap at work or talking about your drug use and partying every night or baby daddy drama, or like when you keep getting locked up in county over and over, or when you leave a ton of negative reviews for other small businesses acting like servers are your servants when you are applying for a server position, or baby mama drama, or these are just the ones I remember off the top of my head, and all these are actual things seen. For your information, be smart people, hide that crap. Ahoho, hire the ones treating servers like crap, let them get a taste. It's not disturbing, but a good story. Before my company had HR, I did the interviews with a couple other people. I interviewed this girl who seemed like a good fit. After the interview I looked her up on Facebook. She had just posted, "I just had a job interview and I think it went well. The pay is crap though." The pay wasn't crap, considering she had no experience. So my first thought was the obvious: I'm not going to hire her. Later that evening I was in Target and I happened to see her there. She didn't see me. She had this big smile on her face and an awesome aura of someone who is very positive. The next day I hired her. 5 years later, she worked her way up pretty high. She has an awesome career in digital marketing now. She has no idea. The pay being fair doesn't preclude it also being crap. I had a reference one tell me that they let the guy go for stalking his ex-wife from the company phones. That was his reference. Not disturbing. The opposite, we interviewed a kid who was a total bag of nerves but seemed good otherwise. Just bad at interviews. When we looked him up, his Facebook said something like, "Crashed and burned in an interview today, really down. I would have loved to get that job." We had a big discussion about whether it was genuine, but I figured if he was playing us, it was worthy of a reward anyway. He worked out great. That's awesome, I'm glad he worked out. Illegal discharge of a firearm from a moving vehicle causing great bodily harm. Man, why bother trying when we said no felons? My boss interviewed him to maybe find out if it was an accident. Nope. Shot his brother in a heated argument after a drive-by they did together. Said brother is now a quad. It's for a bail bondsman agency too. Moron. I am not a manager, but most of my team participates in interviewing potential teammates. I was preparing for an interview and I routinely Google their names to see what comes up. In the past I've been pleasantly surprised to find industry-related accolades that the applicant was too humble to list on their resume. But this time I came up with a long string of blog posts. I got sucked into the rabbit hole at that point and the next 2 hours were spent reading all of these blog entries about his wife who was involved in widespread internet trolling and bullying. There were websites dedicated to how horrible this woman was. People invested in domain names related to the message and paid for hosting just to call her out. So I was left with quite the dilemma. As a result of her bullying, her victims and opponents had dedicated quite a bit of time to doxing her, and as a result her husband and his employer. I figured I would hold on to this information and only inform my boss if we all felt he was a solid candidate that we would hire. The guy came in for the interview and while I was asking him questions the whole time I was thinking about his insane wife, but not saying a word. He somehow worked into the conversation that he had recently divorced, which at the moment further complicated the issue in my mind. When we met as a team after the interviews to discuss how he performed, my boss said he wasn't impressed with his responses to the technical questions and didn't seem like a good fit for the team, which was a huge relief to me. I'm not certain what the right call would have been had he been a good fit. It would be wrong to judge him based upon his ex-wife's actions. But if there's an army of people on the internet targeting her husband's employer in efforts to get him fired, that can be a headache to deal with. If I saw that, my first thought would be that she's the victim of trolling. Decent, normal people don't make websites dedicated to how horrible someone is. Therefore, the websites weren't made by decent, normal people. Sort of on topic. Had an intern that was working with our social media marketing group. She put in a really hateful ticket about how she needed Facebook open on the web gateway filter for her job. So one of the guys on our team looked her up on social media just kind of interested. Here was a big long post about how incompetent IT was at my company and how she had to get on her personal cell phone to browse. We all thought her boss should see her post. She was gone the next day. Seriously, you talk crap behind the boss's back to friends and family, not in a place bosses will find out. Not an employer and not about me. My mother does this about some of her customers on Amazon and eBay. She's a third-party seller on both sites, over Facebook. She once got an order and looked on the person's Facebook. The person was bragging repeatedly there about how she'd scammed multiple Amazon sellers out of inventory and got her money back. She cancelled the order for the textbook via Amazon. The customer asked her why she cancelled it. Mom reported that customer and that pointed out to the customer she shouldn't have her Facebook set on public mode if she wants to scam sellers. I heard that customer was banned from Amazon soon after that. Your mother is a smart woman for doing that. Oh boy, I once interviewed a guy for an entry-level manufacturing position. He was in his mid-30s I guess, and he seemed alright, if not a little socially awkward, and mentioned he wanted the job because he had a baby on the way and wanted something solid as he was picking up odd jobs with a relative's company. This job required basically no skill, so we hired nearly everyone we interviewed. After he left, I went back to my desk and looked him up on Facebook. He was obsessed with Rihanna, photoshopped himself into pictures with her, had her as his cover photo, and had a lot of softcore pee with her head photoshopped onto the models. Nearly every one of his status updates were about her. It was freaking weird as heck. The kicker though was that his profile picture was him with a photoshopped picture of a pregnant Rihanna with his hand on her belly. He did not get a call back. He had a baby on the way and wanted something solid as he was picking up odd jobs with a relative's company. His profile picture was him with a photoshopped picture of a pregnant Rihanna with his hand on her belly. I'm thinking he might not have actually had a baby on the way. Used to be a staffing consultant and had to background check everyone. Had somebody have first degree murder pop up. That was pretty weird considering we do the backgrounds while they're in the office. Had another guy have BND pop and he wanted to explain. He and some friends broke into a co-op and put all the feet against the door so the owner couldn't get in. It was meant to be a prank and now it's on his record. My supervisor wouldn't let hire him, which I thought was lame. Don't do dumb things as adults, kids. A lot of states have expungement laws for scenarios like this. I volunteered at a clinic once to help people clean up their records so they could get better jobs. I interviewed a guy in his late 50s. Hadn't worked for years as he had been a single parent to 4 kids. He passed the interview support position working with elderly people. We then went on to discuss a DBS check, which is where you check any criminal record. He said it would be fine, he didn't have a record. He then asked me about how long records stay on the system for. I said what I am looking for? Forever. Oh, he said, well, I do have something to admit to. My wife said I shouldn't say anything, but I guess I will have to. When my first wife left, I couldn't work because of the kids, so I got involved in P films. I'm not sure how, but it led to films involving kids and was sent to prison. Child abuse images. I hate when people say child pornography. The room went silent. I honestly did not know what to say. I was just aware I was in a room alone in an empty office with this disgusting, vile man. He must have known and said, I will take it, I haven't got the job. I said no sorry and he left. I wish I had said more, but I was so shocked and a bit scared. Red pill and racist pages they've liked or commented on. Some guy had an incredible resume and interviewed really well. Then we saw his comment on Mexicans and Sandy Hook. Yikes, we passed. One guy's profile picture was him with a Friar Tuck haircut doing Edward 40 hands. He had a great interview, but he had to know we were going to check social media. I googled a gal who gave us her resume and she had killed her mother when she was young. Not an employer, but when I was working at my last job, my supervisor would always come up in my suggested friends. I'm quiet and reserved, so she was probably curious. Had a goofy meme PFP and a cover photo of Louis Theroux at the time. Don't think it would have been too disturbing. Not so much Facebook, but I will Google people. I googled an applicant we interviewed and seemed to like. Unfortunately, their top results were losing their nurse credentials for writing fake prescriptions for controlled substances a few years back, and a recent police arrest for driving under the influence and having prescription drugs without a prescription. It actually made me sad, as they seemed likable. Bit off. Unfortunately, not in a place to risk trusting someone with such a poor history of judgment and addiction issues. I recently took a promotion and am working on my replacement in my prior role. The job requires you to be extremely reliable and able to work with generally no supervision. We are taking our time and doing several levels of interviews as well as informal meetings such as dinners or lunches. Those tend to catch people off guard and I get free food. 2 weeks ago I was poking around a lady's FB page and most of it was pretty normal, until I found her comment on an article about a cop shooting a dog. She referenced the owners of the dog as monkeys, the people are African American, and sided with the cop on shooting the chained up dog. Her profile was extremely professional except for the article comments. The monkey comment was just the tip. This woman is a full-bore racist. This is why I pretty much only talk about hockey, cooking, and my yard on Facebook. I guess I won't get hired by someone who has allergies or hates the Blackhawks, but otherwise I should be okay. called a young lady in for an interview and kind of liked her, but she acted a little odd. Checked her FB and it was like redding our trees. It dawned on me that she had been high during the interview. Number. This thread made me realize that my Facebook is pretty clean, but my Twitter would probably destroy any employment opportunities. Oh well. Went through a check a guy that had applied. Has a generally locked down page, but all of the public stuff he'd shared was extremely anti-government. Tinfoil hat bulls. We hold several local and state government contracts, so that crap is a no-go. Went to look up someone that had sent in their resume a year or so ago. We were really short-staffed at work and started looking back at formerly rejected resumes. When we searched her on FB, we found out that the lady was dead. Perfect candidate for graveyard shift. Guns, drugs and stacks of money. The stacks were so small and such small bills that his entrepreneurship seemed limited. At the company I work, each department supports different types of doctors. A guy had been hired to the pediatrics team, had been working for a few months and then was gone. Found out afterwards that he used to be in a high school teacher, but was fired and sent to prison for molesting a student. Pediatrics team. I am a recruiter and when I am screening someone over the phone, I will use their cell number to pull up their Facebook profile. Yep, most of you have your phone number publicly associated linked to your account. Because personality fit is so important with most of the hiring managers, I will see if you like to cause trouble or might not pass a drug test because you like to post pictures of yourself smoking blunts. Most of the time I ask why did you leave your last job, and often they will say something like, lay off, and around that time on their FB timeline there will be some post about how their manager is a B and they walked out Jerry Maguire style. Lesson here is, unlink your phone number from your public FB page. She had a few paragraph long diatribe complaining that she didn't get hired because of her tattoos and piercings and how those B were discriminatory. I made sure that I didn't meet her in person before I told her we weren't hiring. There was a pre-op transgender applicant that had a picture of herself passed out from drinking with one ball hanging out from her pants. I'm fine with stuff like that, but it'd be more appropriate to set that as a private post. You don't have to be fine with everything trans people do. The picture was trashy. This is why I have two Facebook profiles. One is very private, search turned off, and posts and friends list set to private. Profile picture doesn't show my face. Then I have another FB that is very open with pictures of me doing outdoor activities, helping at an animal shelter, posting very positive messages, and member of local groups that look good or show interest in my field of work. Ignore people saying you're crazy. I know a lot of people who do this. People see a private Facebook and assume you have something to hide, not that you just enjoy your privacy. I'll definitely be doing this myself eventually. I want to know how far these background checks go. Will they try to submit friend requests to view private profiles? Do they have shadowy ways to connect my anonymous online accounts with me? No special tools, just a basic search to view public posts. The amount of people whose entire social media profiles are public would surprise you. Twitter profiles are gems too. I was the potential candidate in this scenario and it was my Instagram. But I applied for a job as a receptionist at a real estate office. Before this job, I worked at a gentleman's club and my Instagram was still public. Their response, and subsequent denial, was liking the one photo of me in my old uniform. I changes my settings after that. Who does not lock down their FB account? The pubic can see my banner, which is just a nature photo I took. And image. Not a damn thing else. I assume they already would know what I look like, so that is not a big deal to me. But unless they had some superpowers that I don't know about, they couldn't see anything else. The pubic. Out of pure curiosity, as someone who hasn't had a Facebook account in over 8.5 years, that's a good thing, right? Or do employers actually get suspicious of individuals like me? Not job searching, just curious. Not an employer, but have had this backfire on me. have a fairly uncommon name, but by chance there is a person who's the same age as me and went to the same school. This person has no photos of his face on his profile but a bunch of pictures of weed bong's FTP statuses. The last two jobs I applied for, it was very difficult to say it wasn't me. The worst part was trying to explain that I didn't have a Facebook, which when you say is for privacy reasons, people think you're some kind of crazy conspiracy theorist. I dunno. Employers of Reddit, check my Insta instead of my Facebook if you're thinking of hiring me. I got nothing on Facebook, but I got some cool photos of waterfalls on my Insta. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.